guys, welcome back to this Bar Home and Garden, and today we are going to make a cream of chicken, excuse me if I can get my verbiage right. I was looking in the store and I wanted to do a cream of chicken that, you know, I already had the ingredients for, so I thought that it would be easy enough for us to just go ahead and grab all of our ingredients and just make one from scratch today. We're going to be using it in a broth, a casserole, because I'm going to be making a chicken and broccoli rice casserole, and I thought maybe we could just go ahead and put chunks of chicken in there and do it a little different than most people kind of do. So that's what we're going to be doing today. With the ingredients list, you want to go ahead and bring a little bit, about maybe a teaspoon or so of butter, ready to go into a pan here. And I probably want to put it on like a medium low kind of heat. Consist of, I have some small onions, so I had to use about 3 or 4 onions because they're pretty small. So it'd probably be 1 large onion. And then about a cup of celery, all chopped up. I just used a food processor today, which was pretty easy. Put it on here to get it started. You want to make sure that you have some rice all ready to go and all cooked up. This is a jasmine rice that I'm using. It doesn't matter what kind of rice that you use. You could probably also use cauliflower rice, but you're going to have to brown it. In here and it's cooking, you can start with your chicken. I actually just baked this chicken recently. I put it in the oven. It has 2 packages of some chicken fingers, like this, like little strips. And then it also has 2 or 4 chicken breasts in it. So that should be enough chicken for the whole entire week, including tonight, which is Friday night. The pan underneath it, we're gonna end up putting all of this broccoli in here and mixing it up with the chicken. You're gonna wanna take your rice and stick it also in here. I started doing anything else. got everything cooking up here real nicely, and it's starting to simmer down a little bit. So I'm gonna add some more butter to this. You're probably going to end up using about 4 tablespoons of butter throughout this whole process, because I'm gonna try to get a really nice kind of roux going. We're gonna make this really nice and creamy and thick. I'm gonna salt our rice too. So we've got our butter in here, and I've got tapioca starch. We're going to put the rest of my tapioca starch in here, which is probably about 1/4 cup. It just soaked up that water like no other. See, it's starting to look kind of like gelatin-y. This guy real good, or stir him up real good. Thank you. own pan. Spray, put some of this in there. I'm gonna put a little bit of salt around it. On top. Yes, I am using my hands today. They are clean. They're washing like 10 million times already. Okay, so go ahead and put this in the oven. Usually 30 to 45 minutes. And we'll see what happens when we take it out. I hope it tastes good. It already tastes good, actually. I'm like sitting here eating it. So. And the way that I like to eat it is I like extra pepper on top of it with a little bit of extra salt. And I like the crust. Really yummy in my tummy. Alright, so guys, I'm gonna finish up eating this and I'm gonna wish you guys a happy rest of your week, and I hope you guys don't work too hard, and I hope you inspire to do something wonderful in your life no matter what it is, and inspire other people to do something wonderful in theirs no matter what it is. And I appreciate each and every one of you, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time on Food Aspire Home and Garden. Thanks for all of the wonderful subscribers. Please hit the notification bell and all that fun stuff, and we'll see you next time. Have a good day.